Batul Wadani comes from Jordan, and she has served as her country's NMO president, IFMSA liaison officer, vice president for external affairs, and now the president. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Batul Wadani.
Thank you. To implement change, you need to challenge the status quo. In the 21st century, doctors were killed in Sudan while giving care for patients during civil war. Not acceptable. In the 21st century, millions of people were displaced during a hurricane that hit Zimbabwe and Malawi. Not acceptable. In the 21st century, a community is still under blockade in Gaza. Not acceptable. In the 21st century, women are still fighting for their rights to be equally treated as men. Millions of people around the world are fighting to express their sexuality, and half of the world's population cannot access healthcare services. All of this is simply not acceptable and should not be a status quo. I can go on and on by telling examples of how many things of the status quo around us that we may consider normal and part of our everyday lives. In the 21st century, where humans have reached planets, invented the most important technologies out there, eradicated diseases, but yet, unfortunately, failed miserably to implement equity. Yet what gives me hope is standing here in front of you, who are, before anything else, simply human beings, who may seem very different from different backgrounds from all over the world, yet, as a fact, very similar, being present in one place here today, all with the same opportunity, chance, and voice in our federation. I stand in front of rebels, change makers, leaders, innovators, but most importantly, ones who are eager and not afraid to challenge the status quo in our world. Good evening, everyone. My name is Batul, and it's my biggest honor to stand here in front of you as the president of the organization which gave me a safe space, a harbor, empowered me, and gave me a voice, the International Federation of Medical Students Associations, IFMSA. I have always asked myself, what is the thing that kept IFMSA going since 1951? Is it the efforts of its members, their valuable contributions, their support? Is it the strong structure of our federation or the youth spirit in it? To me, it's one simple word. It's a feeling that is called passion. Passion is the thing that makes you sacrifice your free time to organize a voluntary campaign. Passion is the thing that makes you run tirelessly fundraising for a project and argue with others to write a policy document. But most importantly, passion is the thing that makes you feel angry and upset when hearing about such unacceptable events in countries around us, all around us in the world. Passion is the thing that connects all of us here. We who are very different in religion, in race, in origin, in background, but yet we all speak the same language of passion. I'm also very thrilled and excited to be present here in Taiwan, in Taipei, in a place of freedom where people fought for their rights and implemented equity for generations. It has been a great pleasure to deal and to work with the amazing organizing committee who sacrificed their time, efforts in organizing this inclusive and wonderful General Assembly. And to my dear friend Jasmine, you're such a fierce woman leader who proved to lead a group of team members who are dedicated to organize one of our biggest events in IFMSA. Always with a smile, zero complaints, and the smoothest procedures out there. Thank you so much, Jasmine. I cannot forget as well to thank the most important asset of IFMSA, its workforce. I'd like to ask all the international teams, assistants, program coordinators, and session teams to stand up. and I'd like to ask everyone to look at them, recognize them, and clap their hands for the amazing efforts they've done this year. You can stand up. And to the amazing team of officials, one does not get the chance to choose their team of officials in IFMSA, but if I have the chance to go back in time, I choose each and every one of you. Thank you for the amazing work you've done this year. Thank you for all the contributions you have made. We've gone through so much hardship, overwhelming experiences, and overwhelming work and overwhelming moments as well. Yet we have made it as one team, one big family. I'd like to start calling on stage the executive board, starting from IFMSA Vice President for Activities, Nibosha Nikolic from IFMSA Serbia. IFMSA Vice President for Finances, Ahmed Taha from IFMSA Egypt. IFMSA Vice President for Members, Fabrizio Cannaval from IFMSA Peru. IFMSA Vice President for External Affairs, Marian Sedlak from Slamsa, Slovakia. IFMSA Vice President for Capacity Building, Georg Tvasil from EMSA, Austria. IFMSA Vice President for Public Relations and Communications, Jose Chen from ANEM, Portugal. The Regional Director for Africa, Parth Patel from MSA Malawi. The Regional Director for the Americas, Gabriela Cipriano from IFMSA Peru. The Regional Director for Asia Pacific, Puchin Lee from FMS Taiwan. The Regional Director. The Regional Director for the Eastern Mediterranean region, Adonis Wazir from Lomsek, Lebanon. The Regional Director for Europe, Paulina Birula from IFMSA Poland. SCOMI Director, Katerina Rodriguez from ANEM Portugal. SCOPI Director, Tania Zibrova from HCCM, Russia. SCOF Director, Katia Chish from Slomsek. SCORA Director Ihab Jamal from Associamet Tunisia. And SCORI Director Erwin IFMSA Paraguay. And SCORP Director Idil Kina from Turksek, Turkey. Our Liaison Officer for Medical Education, Katerina Dima from Helmsek, Greece. Our Liaison Officer to Student Organization, Theodore Blidaro from Romania. Our Liaison Officer for Public Health Issues, Tariq Izzin from Associamet Tunisia. Our Liaison Officer for Sexual and Reproductive Health and Rights, including HIV and AIDS, Egle from Limsa, Lithuania. Our Liaison Officer to the World Health Organization, Charlotte from EMSA, Australia. And our Supervising Council, Miguel and Satria Nurshaban. And of course, the Executive Board-elect, Saad Chaibi from IFMSA Morocco and Sania from MSA India. My dear team of officials, thank you for being the unconditional believers, givers, contributors to our federation. We've gone so far, the end seems close, but we're gonna continue it with the same spirit, values, and principles that we have promised our beloved federation. IFMSA has taught us not to accept the status quo and to challenge everything around us. IFMSA taught us not to move with clear conscience when injustice and inequities happen around us. And let me tell you a little secret. Our passion is contagious and literally can change the world. Thank you.